new year, and all that we know, each time the year is starting, different people have different resolutions. What tops the list on each and everyone's resolution is cost cutting. How to save money for that year for other developments. So today, in our Homes and Construction Affairs show, we are looking on how you can save your money back in the kitchen. But guess what? We are looking at bigger institutions. We are looking at schools. We are looking at hotels. Not forgetting our nurseries and prisons. Today I have Masaba Ivan. He's going to break for us how you can use the solar-aided stoves on saving money. Imagine if you've been using like a truck 5 times perhaps a month or 3 months. You can save all that in just one sack of the rocks that we use in these stoves. Join me and we learn how we are going to save money. And this is only found on Urban TV, specifically the Homes and Construction Affairs show.
These are the rocks. I have to have them on site. These are the rocks. Now, this is the normal charcoal. This is normal charcoal. We are going to make sure it takes the least percentage. 30%, as I explained, then the rocks take 70% or 80% even.
Do the rocks have a size specific to be used?
They really don't, because we shall supply you medium size.
So this is how you bring it?
Yeah. Now, I'm going to use a lighter here. This is a carbonized lighter that is smoke-free. However, you can use any other normal thing you always use. All their pine sticks.
Yeah, and others use papers.
Papers.
Others use polythene bags.
Yeah, but we don't emphasize polythene bags here because our rocks are kind of hollow. And if any liquid form falls on our rocks, yeah, you may end up having a smoke. Your kitchen may have smoke all the time. Yet we emphasize smoke-free environment here. So we shall not emphasize or advise you to use polythene papers.
Others use paraffin.
Paraffin. No, it's also not advised. Why? These things are geographically made, so you don't know how it may react on a rock.
Okay.
So we shall stick on lighters. Oh, pine sticks are very common everywhere. They are found. So these are rocks. So I want us to start the process.
So which one are we using?
Let's use the big one because I want to have the clear picture.
Okay.
Now, this is a cone. Before I even light, a cone is you can remove it and put it back. Its importance is to, in case you're preparing milk, ginnas, and all those foods that can pour in case of a lot of heat, they don't pour inside because we don't have to damage the rocks. Okay. So they will pour outer.
On the outer part.
On the outer part. Then the other thing is it collects your heat into one position, so you don't have heat loss here. That's why it is curvy.
As the heat continues to strictly strike on the metal, this tends to shrink or to rust.
The metal?
They wear, it wears out. If it wears out, then what do I do? I come back to you?
First of all, I gave you a warrant of 12 months. That's 1 year. In case, and I said in case of anything,
I come back to
you. Come back to us. Now, we make sure the material you use, because we also know that this cone handles a lot of heat. So make sure the material you use here is extra hard. It is extra. It goes an extra mile compared to other metals on this stove.
Klaus, other people give us spare parts.
Yeah.
For instance, if such a thing
I understand. But in most cases, because we have done this business for some time, after some 3-4 years, when this cone wears out, just take measurements. We do a delivery to your doorstep with a cone. Of course, at a cost. After 3 years, you'll be ashamed not to pay us. So that's it. That's the importance of the cone. Now you can remove it and put it so it is flexible. Now, for starters, we have to remove it before even we start. We place it here. Now I'm going to put my rocks. As I said, this thing is prepared in 4 layers. Rocks first, put charcoal, then light. again put rocks, that is the third layer. Then on top you can put charcoal dust or charcoal in small particles.
That's it.
So here we go. So this sigiri is kind of big, so don't compare it to other ones. Eh?
Okay.
I wanted to use this because I want us to have the clear picture of how this thing operates. So it is big, so it will consume some charcoal, but don't get scared. It is just big. If you're five people, you don't need to use this.
Mm.
Yeah. As you can see, it is also consuming a lot of rocks.
I see.
Uh-huh. Because it is big. Actually, it is the biggest
it is
size.
The bottom, we are good.
Yeah. So we are going to first put this kind of rocks.
Yes.
Not too much.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll put our charcoal here. So make sure I don't put this because we want a smoke-free kitchen, a smoke-free environment.
So it is either rock. Actually, only rocks,
the
lighter,
and
charcoal.
Yeah. So, I want us to light now. Just like a normal sigiri.
Mm.
For this lighter, you'll break it into two.
Okay.
Hey, break it into two. Please make sure your charcoal is clean and of good quality. At least try. I know a lot of poor quality is around, but let's try. So, as I told you, that lighter is smoke-free. You see, it is carbonized, eh? So no smoke you'll be having when you use that lighter. Uh-huh. Unless it shuts before. So okay, we make sure it burns out. If it doesn't burn out, that's when it will bring the smoke. But if it is burning, it will not.
Mm.
Just like a normal sigiri, right? You construct your small house. For us who are used to this, here we shall come to our fan. This is fan number two. Number one, sorry.
Oh, after this?
Uh-huh. So you make sure you turn your fan on, eh?
Mm-hmm.
You turn your fan
on. At that point, won't it blow out?
Mm, it won't. Don't put too much to blow it out. Eh?
Mm.
Hey.
Okay.
Put something small just to support it.
Is it on already?
Yeah, it is on, but not at maximum.
Mm.
Eh? Hey.
Oh, I put this already. Like, I put it early.
No, it is fine. It also prevents this wind that comes from this side to blow this thing. So we can add just a little bit on our fan here. And remember, this is a big burner. If it was a small one, but this one is a big one. So you have to. So the briquettes, you light them like the normal charcoal. Put them inside, the same process we have used here. Now for the honeycomb, it is always better to have like already 2 lit like charcoal pieces. You just have your like two, let's say these already have, they already have fire, eh? They already red hot.
So you must have charcoal
for it.
That is already lit.
Uh-huh, for the honeycomb, then you place them down.
Mm-hmm.
You make it sit on top.
What?
Hey.
Only two?
Two, right enough. It will take some time, around 10 to 15 minutes to light. But once it lights, you'll see the difference. Once it lights, it can go for 6 hours, non-stop.
So you must be ready.
Ready. If your beans are there, let them be there. If your food is there, it'll be there.
Like
because if it lights, it is uncontrollable.
One dish, you put another dish, you put another dish.
Hey.
Okay.
So for its sake, it is just like that.
For it after that,
It is wasted.
It turns to ash.
Uh-huh. To dust, actually. Mm. Hey, it is not reusable.
For
the briquettes, you just start them like normal charcoal. Put your nail sigiri, get a cavera or what?
Mm.
You're good to go.
Okay.
For the rocks, don't use a cavera. I think you can increase a little bit on the fan now.
Okay.
Hey. So.
Mm.
If now this layer has got some heat, if it is well lit, then again you add on rocks. So you make sure the rocks take the big percentage. Now since we're not going to cook anything here, we are going to just add rocks. We're not going to add charcoal.
Then there's one thing you mentioned about these rocks, that they are reusable.
Mm.
At what point how do I
now this is the example I can give. If you put this rock into your sigiri, you have to make sure it reduces to this size.
When you put it there, when it is this size,
it will reduce slowly.
It has to reduce.
It's just a gradual process, but it will reduce with time.
My question is, I have used the rocks, I have prepared my meals, and I'm done. So how do I get the light off?
You just turn the fan off, just like gas.
When you turn the fan off, the fire
will go off slowly. Yeah, it will go off.
Then when I'm going to use it again?
You'll do the same process we have done.
I first
you clean the stove, you get the ashtray, clean the ashes, you put the rocks, then you put the rocks again.
Okay,
so it is, you just do the same process we have done here.
So they reduce up to when it's ash as well?
No, they won't see ash, but they will reduce gradually.
Hey. Until when I have nothing
left. You have a very small size. That's when you can make a replacement.
As they're reducing, can't it also like affect the usage?
As in?
You know, like when you are washing, we know that the bar, when you get this piece, when it's still full, its effect on a cloth is different as when you're remaining with that one which is shrink. You know, it shrinks slowly. So the toughness tends to calm down as it is shrinking. How is it with the
Of course, also the toughness will reduce. Because if it is a new rock, you will also feel it. The heat will be as much as expected. But as time goes on, you will see that it is also reducing. It loses energy as time goes on.
So like how many rounds can I use this?
This we don't count them in rounds because it is hard to count in rounds. People are different homes. Have different meals a day.
I'm giving you an example.
Breakfast, lunch, supper. It will take between 4 and 6 weeks. That's close to 2 months. Yeah.
2 months.
2 months. Yeah.
I'm preparing simple. It's beef, chicken,
chigere. Even if you're preparing chigere, molokon, or whatever.
Irish.
Yes.
Those simple.
Also,
milk.
Yeah. It can go. Even their people, their clients, I know, their rocks take over 3 months because they cook one meal, 2 meals a day.
Wow.
So what when I say between 4 and 6 weeks, that's the maximum usage of this rock.
So now it's like how far is now?
Yeah, it is. Yeah, it is becoming ready.
So what do I do at this stage?
No, let's first wait for it to, because I don't want to wait a lot when I put on the last layer.
You
so let's let's give it some other time.
Now for the grilling bits, which one is the part, which stove do I use for grilling?
When I mentioned the packages I'm having at the moment, there were packages that had ovens and grills. So I don't advise you to grill using this. Because as I said,
what does the other one do?
This is a firewood I did, as Ivan is will take you through in the next episode. They will take you through that. So since our nyama sometimes brings those liquid forms, watery things, of which we don't encourage liquid forms, any liquid forms to fall into our sigiri. So that's why we always give a grill as part of the package for you to grill your nyama, maize and all that.
My question now is, this example you've given us has an oven. May I know how this connects? Oh, I have a different section.
Yeah, you have a different section. Now, for the oven, that's where we light. It has a liner inside there.
How do you know?
So just rail it out, light it, then put your charcoal. The same process.
So,
now these are used up.
They are used up completely, or I can still
reuse. These are used up now.
So
you can even feel it is not heavy as
so
it was.
Can't do
anything. Cannot.
Now this is for disposing.
Now those ones have to be disposed. It's just because we rarely use the oven here. Yeah.
Now for us who cook with ovens, we have regulators. To regulate the heat. How is it with
even this has a regulator here, though you won't have.
That's a fan.
Of course, the fan regulates the amount. When the faster the fan runs, the more the heat is produced. So I'm going to add on rocks there. Yeah, it is now ready. So now we are going to, if you're going to cook foods like chigere, beans, meat, those long time whatsoever, what you do is you add on rocks, and again you add on charcoal to make the four layers. But if you're going to cook things like matoke, porridge, rice, now for example we are cooking nothing at the moment, so we're just going to put our rocks. We put the fan at maximum, so you just have the flames of the fire going through the rocks. Maybe you can put a saucepan of water, maybe here. Yeah.
If I'm going to have my omelette.
Omelette, you just make two layers.
Like
rocks, charcoal. Just put rocks and charcoal. So I think you can see, you can testify that we are putting more rocks than charcoal. So I want us to have these rocks turn red hot. You will see the fire flames going through the rocks. So that's how the saving mode comes in.
So what is the cost of that stone?
As I said earlier, rocks are served or they are sold. Okay, we make annual packages. So if you, we make any packages.
What is that now, package for the year?
Now, if you have two burners, each package, they vary also. Because the rocks that are consumed by two burners, they totally differ from those ones consumed by the four burners.
Now we have a two burner.
Two burners, it is
with
one.
With an oven.
With an oven, it is 100,000.
For a year?
For a year.
You're kidding.
I'm not kidding. So the annual supply is 100,000. I think the.
For a year?
Yeah. The most expensive one is for four burners. It is 200 a year.
So what is that you give? How, what's the...
It's, we give you a bag of 50 kg when you have two burners. Then if you have four burners, it's 100 kg. They take you for a year, even beyond.
Sure.
I am sure.
A 50 kg
it does.
Bag lasts
it does.
A year.
It does because the replacement is made, I think, five times a year. Five times a year. That's when you change. So that's a very good idea. It's a good deal. Remember, the rocks you once put in are reusable. You get my point, they are reusable. So here, the heat is already up. You can start cooking at the moment. But I want us to have the fire flames. That's why the fan is at maximum. But remember, we put not too much charcoal. We just made sure the rocks take the bigger percentage
here.
We are
using the charcoal
because
to help ignite fire on the rocks.
I want us to save here on money, charcoal, time. I want us to cook while standing in our comfort zones. I want us to enjoy a smoke-free kitchen. I want us to eat on time. I think you can testify that no smoke is here.
Yeah, apparently.
No smoke.
I haven't seen smoke. When I sit, I'm going to let
No smoke. No smoke. If you
because
are to
I'm
sit,
so
you would have experienced that some time back, but
you know, my concern and my focus earlier was on the chimney because
we don't need
to control the smoke.
No, you don't need that.
So now,
as I said, you just need to tile the upper part of your stove just to ease the cleaning. Maybe you're repairing porridge, it spills over the wall and all that. You just have a cloth, mop your tile, you're good to go. So it's very easy to maintain. It is very clean, or is that it cooks fast, you eat on time, the saving is assured almost 70%, because as you've seen, rocks have taken the biggest percentage.
Now, if I have a request as a client that instead of tiling here, I request for granite to marble, do you do
the... We have done all those things, because different clients have
different tastes. True.
So you may find someone who wants slate on top. Once marble, we have done that. Yeah, you'll have some pics to show the our viewers. They'll have a look and experience different packages with different finishing points.